Hello, I'm Zander Leong, Verde Magazine's webmaster and a senior at Palo Alto High School. Today, I'm joined by a panel of artists, and together we'll be analyzing scenes from the Netflix original Hilda. Do you guys want to go around and introduce yourselves?
Hello. I'm Selena. I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Joey. I'm also a senior at Palo Alto High School.
Hello, I'm Samantha. I'm the art director on Verde Magazine. And a senior, yay!
Yay, yeah, thank you guys so much for joining me today. All right, let's get started with our first clip. This is from episode 7, which is called The Lost Clan. We'll kind of be jumping around episodes a little bit. So I'll just run through the video one first time, and then we can go back through it and discuss.
I kind of hoped we'd be setting out into a deep, dark forest.
The library is a forest for the imagination.
And research the greatest adventure of them all. I like him.
Okay, yeah, do you guys have any initial thoughts?
So cute! Oh my god!
Yeah! I really like this scene.
Yeah, oh my gosh. I think their library, it feels very, like, atmospheric.
Yeah, I like the dust particles.
Yeah,
like in the air, and then there's also that that foreshortening.
Oh,
not the... foreshortening, like sort of perspective. One, yeah. Where the girl is how tall is she? Like,
they're all like they're like the height of a couch, kind of.
They're like the height of a third grader. They're like young.
Oh, okay. It's just like. Cool to see how small they are compared to the bookshelves.
Yeah, I definitely agree. And also I think like the composition, like there's kind of a focus here and like the rest is kind of blurred out depth of field, but still like draws you down towards her.
One thing I really like about Hilda is the color palette, and I feel like this scene kind of encapsulates some of that because it's very muted and kind of brown toned, but it's also they do a good job, and like this is a super common trick in animation of making the main characters a lot brighter to just kind of make them stand out. And I think this is just it's beautiful in terms of composition and color and animation. Mm-hmm. It's a good scene.
I definitely agree. Everything looks like the color really ties everything together. Like everything looks like it belongs together. It all kind of just looks cohesive. And going back to the perspective thing, I think it kind of, I guess, exaggeration of like a size, like how big the books are compared to the character. Like exaggeration is a big thing in animation, and I guess they really push that perspective to show how daunting these and tall these bookshelves really are.
Yeah, that's a really good point, I guess, because she's also saying like she'd rather go into a forest than like a library. So definitely like it kind of shows how, like you said, daunting it is to her. And then like the other characters say like, oh, it's a forest of like knowledge for the imagination or something. So it definitely kind of gives that foresty, like a tree trunk kind of feel, I think.
Yeah, no, I was just gonna add to what you said about like the color. Like it's a very red, orange, autumn-y sort of color palette, like you said. But then they also have that blue. And like, I think the blue is the only one that isn't part of the monochromatic scheme. And like the main character, or like one of the main characters, like her hair is like blue.
It's just got that soft, like, I don't know, nostalgic, I guess. I don't know, like in the afternoon when that nice orangey light just shines through the window.
I think Selena described it as autumn-y was a good choice.
Mm-hmm.
It definitely got those vibes, as well as the lighting. They do a good job with the lighting.
Yeah, especially with the dust particles.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Go back to the scene where that scene, like that beautiful sense of light coming in. I just love that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. So with that, why don't we move on to the second clip? It's a little bit longer than the first one, I believe, and it's from the first episode, which is called The Hidden People.
Run!
Ooh. Right, so definitely a bit more going on than the last clip we saw. But do you guys have any thoughts?
The Man, the sense of weight. Oh, like you really get that bouncy feeling from these characters. Like the animation's so smooth. That stretch and squish though.
Ooh.
Yeah, I remember watching this for the first time and I loved the style because it's a lot different than it's like I think people kind of describe it as like the CalArts style of very like round characters, but I feel like it has such a difference in color palette than a lot of like animated stuff that like it kind of works out.
I feel like kind of when you think of like children's animation, you think like really bright, clashy, saturated colors. But one thing with Hilda, like the entire show, it really flips that script and shows that, you know, children's shows can be really beautifully colored as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think an interesting stylistic choice is how they chose not to gradient the sky. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, I like that. It like the choice in colors and like kind of the vibes of using color as kind of a mechanism to storytell definitely reminds me of Steven Universe, and like that just makes me happy. I'm sorry.
The style of drawing like also partially reminded me of Gravity Falls.
Yeah, and it's definitely like more action-y. I feel like the time of day and like the colors they chose really add to that intense, like edge of your seat kind of feel.
And the music as well.
Oh yeah. Do you want to listen to it a bit?
Ooh.
There's like drum beats, like the
Yeah.
bell jingling.
It paces well with her running and stuff. I think they did a good job of timing it.
Definitely, yeah. This particular like shot, I also thought was really interesting. Like, there's like so much movement, kind of cuts across the screen. Like she goes over the log, the pet goes like under the log, kind of like curves around. Thought that was
Yeah.
really compelling.
It's the S. The S.
Oh, the S curve.
The
S curve.
And I was also gonna I noticed her beret, just like it's like supposed to be attached to her head, but then like on some like when she's like bouncing, like it just like pops off a little, and I don't know, like just that detail.
It definitely gives a different sense of movement to the character. And same thing with the fox, you got kind of like a smoother feel with the animation, even though it's like frame by frame, it's really rough.
Right. Yeah. I guess also another thing concerning movement is this, like the troll. Like you said, Samantha, you can like feel the weight kind of not only like with the camera shake with each step, but also like the way it slides. And like the dust and how it has to get up.
I think in that one scene where they just show the feet, you can really see the weight, like how they move faster, you know, they have like a faster speed than the monster. And I think that really showcases that sense of weight, that scene right there. Like how that foot just lingers there for a moment at the bottom.
Yeah.
I like the dust.
Yeah.
You really like dust, Selena.
But yeah, no, I feel like, especially in Hilda, just the small details add so much. But yeah, with that, why don't we move to our final clip? This one is the longest of all of them that we've seen so far. It's from episode 4, which is called The Sparrow Scouts. Yeah, I'll just play it.
Ready to go to your very first Sparrow Scout meeting?
Almost.
Oh, I hope you like the Sparrow Scouts as much as I did at your age. Come on, we don't want to be late. What are you doing?
Looking for my sweater.
You're wearing it.
No, my good sweater. Guess I'll have to wear this one.
Hey, I knitted you that sweater.
All right. Yeah. So this is, it shows her mom, Johanna. So this is kind of like they moved into the city, which is called Trollberg. This is like their new house. And they're kind of settling into life there.
I remember watching this, and I like all these scenes because I think they're really fun, and I think this show's really fun. But like, again, with the color palette and the sense of light, I really enjoy that. And the style is just, it's just always so beautiful. As well as like, it gives it a sense of like childlike wonder of like her looking at all these places and trying to find what we eventually find out to be her sweater. And like, obviously it's not going to be under the pot, but as a kid, like you don't care. You're just going to lift up the pot. It's just, and the music timed with it, it's just great.
Yeah. That's something I was actually thinking about too, Joey. Like, I don't know about you guys, but I'd totally see myself like, oh, I need my good sweater. Like, it's in the cabinet. It's under the pot. It's like, I'm looking everywhere. She has like this little kind of angry expression, like when it's not there.
Yeah, so I just noticed like the squishiness of the cushions on the couch. I really like that detail because like you really, it's just, it feels like a sponge when you look at it, or like at least like a cushion.
Something that I really appreciate is, I don't want to say it's unclean, but it's not totally clean line art. Like, it's kind of, they're using like a brush that isn't just straight. Like, you can see in some of the more detailed shots where it's kind of like a fuzzy brush.
Yeah.
It looks like a how there's sketching like, brush.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah.
I forget who said it, but somebody said something about the sky and not kind of blending together a lot of the colors. But that has like a very, when you look at it up close, it has a very like obvious difference between all the colors, but like when you're just kind of watching the show, you don't really see it. You just kind of think it's blended together when it's not.
Yeah, definitely, like it, you can really tell it's a sense of lighting, and it's not just like colors on the can or something.
Yeah.
Also, there's like another show of the really good lighting. I think if you fast forward a little bit, where she's like, yeah.
Ooh.
And then like you can still see like the dust particles. They're like really consistent about that with it. Like.
Yeah, it's something so small, but I feel like it adds a lot.
Yeah.
Going back to color, they do use colored line art in some places, and that also adds to like that autumny feel and also makes everything look unified.
Yeah, a more neutral tone. And then like you got the classic black outline for a lot of the characters.
Yeah.
Or interactive objects. So
something stylistic that I really like is just the little mark on like the empty spaces. It just breaks up those blank walls.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, it gives, I don't know, it gives kind of a, I guess like a lived in kind of feel. Like it's not perfect. There's like little nick marks, but it adds kind of personality.
I appreciate the wood texture on the bench.
Yes.
They're really good at like making details, but like not so much that it becomes like too much.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
I think that's a hard balance sometimes to hit, but they do a good job, just like everything has the same amount of detail, so your eye never gets attracted to something that's, you know.
Yeah,
that perspective though.
That's exactly what I was gonna say.
Look all those lines. Wow.
Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. Focal point.
Also, I feel like just like in this opening sequence, so the show is adapted from like a comic book, and I feel like that kind of comes through in some of the scenes. Like I could see this in a comic book, like all the different shots,
especially with the perspective. Like you can tell, because comic art, since it's not moving, or like it has to show movement in different ways, and perspective is like a huge part of that. So I think like keeping those elements of both, like I think the line art is a huge part, and I think the perspective is a big part.
Yeah, I think that's a good place to wrap up. Again, thank you guys so much for joining me. This was the Hilda Scene Analysis by Verde Magazine. If you want to check out more content, you can visit our website at verdemagazine.com. There you can read the full review on Hilda or other like TV and film reviews. You can also find cool news articles, feature stories, and multimedia elements as well. So definitely check that out if you're interested. I'm Zander Leong, and this was the Hilda Scene Analysis. Thank you. Bye.